I love that, looks good.
Hi. Thank you.
No, thank you.
Huh?
Everybody's going. Hey, but you guys right though, right?
Everybody's going.
Take one more. One, two, and
I want to thank everyone for being here. Before we get started, I'd like to bow our heads and go to the Lord with prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for Mia, for this time of joy and celebration on her quinceañera. Father, it's truly an inspiration to see a young adult willfully choose to follow you. I pray that you would use her as a vessel to reach the lost and share the gospel. Make her bold in her witness, removing all fear and anxiety. God, we pray that Mia keeps your word close to her heart and follows it daily as she lives a life that is both centered around and honoring to you. God, give her strength to resist temptation and to stand firmly against peer pressure. May all relationships she develops with others be healthy and pure. Let her stand out to the world as she embraces her faith in you, no matter what the cost. May she be a light that shines in the darkness. I pray all these things in the mighty, matchless name of Jesus, our Savior. And everybody said, amen. Amen. Mia, first, I want to congratulate you on this special day, marking your transition from childhood to maturity. I would imagine you're feeling a mixture of excitement and anxiety, as we had discussed, and that's all right. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 11 says, "When I was a child, I spoke and thought and reasoned as a child. But when I grew up, I put away childish things." Today marks that transition from a girl to a young woman. Appropriately, you are surrounded by your closest family and friends. These are the people who have had a tremendous influence in who you are today. And with the help of God and some persistence on their part, will continue to pour into you through the coming seasons of your life. Mia, you and I had a chance to spend a little time together recently. You shared some of the things you're most passionate about. Some of those things were volleyball, hanging out with your friends, and mostly spending time with your family. I want to break those down a little bit. I think volleyball has been a big part of your life. It's also something that has taken a lot of hard work on your part, especially in order to play at a competitive level. And as a matter of fact, you've had to work extra hard. That is one of life's greatest lessons, and it translates to every area of our lives. If it's worth pursuing, it's going to take extra effort on your part. Are there any Spurs fans in the house?
Yeah.
Yes, some Spurs fans? So I was blessed to go to church with one of the Spurs assistant coaches, Coach James Borrego, and got to know him pretty well. Coach Borrego is an amazing man, and he's committed. He's a committed man of God. He once told a story of a sign that hangs in the Spurs locker room. The sign has three simple words on it. It says, "Pound the rock." You might think, what does that have to do with basketball? Let me share. It references the way that they would split huge boulders with a hammer and a series of wedges. And sometimes it would take hundreds of blows to split that boulder. Maybe 300 swings. You'd hit the boulder, and eventually it would fall into two pieces. But here's the takeaway. It wasn't the 300th blow that split the boulder. It was the contribution of every blow from the first one to the final one that split the rock. You can imagine that while they were hitting that rock the first 100 times, they may have gotten a little frustrated. The next 200 swings would have certainly led to times of wanting to give up. But then the 300th blow came, and the rock split. Their persistence paid off, and it will be no different in your life, Mia, as you continue to pursue countless challenges. Galatians 6 and 9 says, "So let's not get tired of doing what is good, for at the right time, we will reap a harvest of blessing if we don't give up." Mia, don't give up. When you're doing what is good, don't give up. Pound the rock. You mentioned that you love spending time with your friends, hanging out. And I want to talk about the power of spending time with the people we choose as our closest friends. It's been said many times, show me your friends and I'll show you your future. It's also been said, you are an average of the five people you spend the most time with. Think about that for a second. The people you spend the most time with will shape the person you become. As you take a look around at the friends you've surrounded yourself with, beautiful friends, those that are here to support you on this very special day, I go back to Scripture. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, the old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. That is the new you as you transition your life from childhood to a young adult. So it's going to be especially important to anchor yourself in Christ. It's also critical that you continue to surround yourself with friends that speak words of life into you. Friends who will speak grace and truth. It's important to include both grace and truth in all of our dealings with others. Jesus was the best example of this. When he was speaking to the woman at the well who had been living a life of sin, he didn't condemn her. Jesus said to her, your sins are forgiven. That was grace. But then he followed it with, now go and sin no more. That was truth. You see, truth without grace is mean. But grace without truth is meaningless. I also want to mention that every time grace and truth are mentioned in the Bible, grace precedes truth. And that is spiritual order. Another passion you shared was time with your family. How important that is to you. A man once misquoted Einstein's theory of relativity and said, time passes most slowly when you're with your relatives. That's not true. But Mia, that definitely doesn't apply to you and your family. You specifically mentioned that some of your best times are when your whole family is together. Whether you're at a party, at a park, or at the coast, it's most fun when you are all present and investing time with each other. Parents, grandma, brothers and sisters, cousins, aunts, uncles. Mia, you have an amazing heart, a heart so full of love for others. It really touched me that one of your favorite things to do is to go next door and spend time with Grandma Josie. When I asked you what you do together, you said that she explains a lot of what's going on in the world. And I thought that was so mature of you as a young woman to recognize the wisdom of those that have more life experience than you and to invest the time to learn from those experiences. Be a sponge. Soak it in. Another thing I found amazing was the fact that you told me in 15 years, you and your brother Mark and your sister Kaylin have never had a single fight. That's not true. I'm watching out for lightning. You actually said that you guys bicker all the time. And that's not abnormal. That's very normal. Because sometimes we're hardest on the people that are closest to us. We hold them to the highest standard. But always remember grace and truth. Grace before truth. And when it comes to siblings, that will be your ultimate test. Challenge accepted? Yes. I also want to take a moment and honor your parents and the influence that they've had in your life. Over the last few years, I've had a couple opportunities to spend some time with your mom and dad. And I have to say, they're amazing examples of loving people who are willing to be sacrificial for the sake of their loved ones. Mark and Letty, thank you for allowing me to be part of this special day. Your love for the Lord, your love for your children and your family are worthy of celebration. This world is a better place because of your efforts and your hard work. I see you two as swans, beautiful and having it all together on the surface. But I know that under the surface, you've been doing a lot of paddling to make it happen. Because children like Kaylin, Mark, and now Mia, they don't just develop themselves. It takes your hard work. So thank you for your willingness to do the work to develop amazing children. I also want to honor many generations of family members, many that have passed, some, Mia, that you've never had a chance to meet. But Mia, I know that you recognize that there have been people that poured into people that poured into people that then poured into you. Some of those people are represented here with candles. I know they are here in spirit, and they're smiling down on you, celebrating with the angels in heaven at the young woman that you have become. This love is generational. It transfers from parent to child to child to child. When we think of things that are generational, it's so common to go to negative things, things we call generational curses, things like anger, addiction, or broken relationships. Yes, those things are generational, but so are good things. Love is generational. Goodness is generational. In Galatians 5 and 22, they call those the fruits of the Spirit. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. They're all generational, and they will transfer from you to your children, to your children's children. Finally, I'd like to honor another form of extended family that played a significant role in this very special day. People like Bernice, your godmother. She's been there for you and consistently checked in as a voice of love and consistency in providing you additional security in not only who you are, but the path that you're on. Family can be defined in many ways. There certainly is family members that share a bloodline, but there's also people we consider family that share a character line, that share commonality. Those people probably don't show up on our list on ancestry.com, but they're family nonetheless. Some of those people have served as sponsors for this special day. They've shared their time, they've shared their talents, they've even shared their treasures to make this day happen. And without them, this day wouldn't have happened. So a huge thank you to everyone that played a role in making this day possible. It's because of this outpouring of love that Mia personally picked the people to provide her quince gifts, which makes them even more special. And Mia, as I finish up, I want to offer you three statements that I read in a devotional, and I think they're perfect for your special day. If you live into these statements and lean into these statements, you will generate a powerful identity that will carry you far beyond this world. Here they are. Number one, be secure as a woman. In this world, it's so easy to feel lost. There will be so many different things that will try to convince you that they will be your compass, your true north. But I want to encourage you to anchor yourself in your faith. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 and 6 says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and do not lean into your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him and he will make straight your paths." People often inflate the rating of their spiritual health by confusing it with their current emotional health. And I want to challenge you to choose to trust God even on the days when it's difficult or you may not feel like trusting God. I have personally found in my life that there have been times that I have felt extremely close to God and times when I have felt far from God. In those times when I did not feel as close to God, here's a fact. God didn't move. God was right there. Whatever the season you're going through, seasons of strength and triumph, or seasons of struggle, God is right there with you. Put your anchor in God and not in your shifting emotions. Philippians chapter 4, verses 6 and 7 says, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And in the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your mind in Christ Jesus." I want to stay with the idea of emotions and challenge you to think about where you place them. When you are scared, where do you go? When you are mad, where do you turn? When you are lonely, who do you reach out to? I want to encourage you to turn to Christ. Turn to God. Invite God into those challenging times, never to shame you. But as Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. Proverbs chapter 31, verses 25, 28, and 29 says, strength and dignity are her clothing. She laughs at the time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and the teaching of kindness is on her tongue. Many women have done excellently, but you surpass them all. As you practice making Christ the central driving force in your decisions and the place where you turn when you feel lost, you will gain a profound strength. You are only as strong and secure as the things you trust in, and nothing is stronger and more secure than God. Statement number two, be courageous as a woman. Today more than ever, we need powerful leaders in our world. Right now, I'm calling out the courageous leader in you, Mia. You mentioned that your favorite scripture was, for we walk by faith, not by sight. That's 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7. With Christ as your compass and the place of your trust, you will be an example for not only your peers, but also for the adults around you. Psalms 34 and 5, look, those who look to him for help will be radiant with joy. No shadow of shame will darken their faces. Do not walk in shame. Your worth, Mia, is immeasurable. God gave his son to adopt you into his family. Be brave, be bold, the daughter of the king. Isaiah 41 and 10, fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you, I will help you, I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Let me say it again, be brave, be bold, daughter of the king. How do you do that? With your family, the family of God, standing by you as you fight temptation and distraction, and also as you help others fight temptation and distraction. Be brave, Mia. And point number three, statement number three is be loved as a woman. Romans 8 and 28, and we know that for those who love God, all things work together for good, and for those who are called according to his purpose. You personally do not have the ability to understand the same way God does, but you do have his heart, Mia. And when you are confused, remember, you are loved, and in the end, God will make things right and fair. Trust in him. Psalm 139:14, I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works. My soul knows it very well. You are not only the daughter of the king, you are made by him and for a purpose. You are loved, you are wanted, and you are worthy. Ephesians 2 and 10, one of my favorite verses. I wear it on dog tags every day. It says, for we are God's masterpiece, created anew in Christ Jesus to do the good things he planned for us long ago. You are still being formed. You are still being shaped. And when this life feels like a workout, guess what? It is. You're being shaped right now and being made into something even more beautiful. God has a plan for you. At this time, I'd like to ask the sponsors to come forward. We'll prepare to bless the gifts. And while they're coming forward, I'm just going to share a couple of final thoughts. Mia, your best is yet to come. I believe it wholeheartedly. But even more importantly, God believes in you. Walk in his promise, and you won't only be truly beautiful, you will make everything you connect with more beautiful too. Go to prayer. Father, we lift up these gifts in honor of your unending and unconditional love for Mia on this amazing day. Father, I pray over each element of her celebration adornment, and that she remembers the symbolism behind each one. May she remember that the Bible she carries upon her quinceanera be a reminder to keep your word close to her heart and to follow it daily. May she remember the bear as a representation of her transition to womanhood and leaving childish ways behind. May she remember that her beautiful dress serves as the armor of God protecting her as she leads a life serving you. May she remember that her tiara symbolizes that you shall place a greater crown on her head in heaven. Here on earth, she is a princess of God. And may she allow her jewelry to serve as a reminder to listen for your voice, surround herself with your teachings, and as a symbol of her purity and commitment to leading a life that honors you. God, we thank you for Mia and for this blessed event marking her 15th birthday. May she continue to love and be faithful to her family and her friends. Bless her with your love and your divine favor as she grows in wisdom, knowledge, and grace. God, surround her with your hand of protection as she boldly steps forward to live out the plan and purpose that you have placed on her life. May you be the lamp to her feet and the light to her path. Guide her and instruct her. Help her to lean into your presence and encourage her heart daily. We ask all this in the mighty name of Jesus. And everybody said, amen. Everyone's going to just take a few minutes and we'll enjoy some music while we get ready for dinner. Thank you.
Mía. We're going to sing las mañanitas for you. Mañanitas para mía.
Oh my lord. Oh my.
Vamos a cantarle las mañanitas para mía.
Estas son las mañanitas que cantaba el rey David. Hoy por ser día de tu santo, te las cantamos aquí. Despierta, mi bien, despierta. Mira que ya amaneció, ya los pajarillos cantan, la luna ya se metió.
Dame la fuerza para vivir.
vendrá.
Presentation. We will start off by presenting the Court of Honor. A round of applause as we begin. Starting off, we have Taylor Nicole with Julio Olivares. A round of applause, everyone. Next up, we have Leila Acosta with Christopher Ortiz. Coming up next, we have Alexis Arevalo with Jaden Andrew Olivares. Next up, we have Samantha Chapa with Patrick Ortiz. Now, give it up for Kaylee Guzman and Andrew Rodriguez III. Next up, we have Gabriela Mary Padilla with Aiden Ray Olivares. A round of applause, everyone. Next up, we have Kiara Valdez Martinez with JJ Acosta. A round of applause, everyone. Now, our main escort of the night, we got Jacob Tovar. Now, give it up for the grandmother, Josie Ramos. Accompanied by Mark and Kaylin Garcia, siblings. We can please have everyone stand up as we are about to receive our quinceañera of the night. A round of applause for Mary Ann Garcia alongside her parents, Mark and Lady Garcia. Que se escuchen los aplausos. Our presentation of the gifts. A round of applause as we receive people to the floor. Starting off our presentation of the gifts, we have Bernice and Luis Alvarez presenting the crown. A round of applause, everyone. Coming up next, presenting the Bible, we have Chris and Laura Tolbar. A round of applause, everyone. Next up, presenting the earrings, we have Pete, Michelle, and Evangeline Ramos. Round of applause, everyone. We have Francis, Ryan, and Richie Orta presenting the necklace. Presenting the bracelet. Coming up next, we have Grandma Josie Ramos presenting the ring. A round of applause, everyone. Coming up next, presenting the last goal, we have John and Amanda Tolbar. Now, last but not least, we have Mark and Kaylin Garcia presenting the shoes. Round of applause for the siblings. Kaylin Garcia. Now give it up one more time for Quinceanera of the Night, Mia. And that, ladies and gentlemen, concludes our presentation of this. Coming up next, we have our father-daughter waltz. Dad, please stay on the dance floor so that we can begin. Give it up, ladies and gentlemen, for Joe, for Mia, and Mark. Coming up next, we have our mother-daughter waltz. And we can please have Mom join us on the dance floor so that we can begin. Give it up, ladies and gentlemen, for Letty and Mia.
Be, and though she'll grow and someday leave. hope you see how happy she made me.
Give it up, get it one more time for Mia and Larry. And that, ladies and gentlemen, concludes our mother-daughter waltz. In a few moments, we'll begin with the court waltz. For a code of honor tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Code of honor, if we can please have you stay at the dance floor for a quick picture. And that, ladies and gentlemen, concludes our waltz of the night. Coming up next, we'll be doing a small toast.
A drink in their hand. I want everyone to toast along with us on this special occasion. Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to thank each and every one of you for making my daughter's day very special. This has been a great journey. Thank you so much for being a huge part for all of our family and our sponsors and our friends. Our family, really. They're not our friends, they're our family. Thank you so much, and Mia to the court, thank you guys for enduring all of the practices and all the headaches along with us, but it's all for Mia and Garcia. This is your day. Happy 15th birthday, babe. I love you. Salud.
I would like to say a little speech myself. I would like to thank, again, like Mark said, our family and friends. As he mentioned, our friends are not friends, they're actually our family. I also would like to thank my Holy Cross family for backing me up, because today was a hectic day. They just did a lot when I wasn't there. There was so much to be proud of, and I don't even know what to say, but I'm just so excited, and I just really want to thank everybody from the bottom of my heart who went through us throughout this entire journey.
Hello. Oh. I would also like to say thank you to everyone here, all my friends and family, all my sponsors. I would like to say thank you for putting your money, your efforts, to putting something for me. My core, their parents, thank you for taking time out of your day to come to practice, and especially my parents, thank you for letting me have a quinta and letting me be able to have one. Yeah. yeah, thank you.
Give it up one more time for Mia and the Court of Honor. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our presentation of the night. Get the form started. Don't be shy. We're waiting for you at the dance floor. Come on. We need everyone over here to the dance floor.
Wobble, baby, wobble, baby, wobble, baby, wobble, baby, wobble, baby. Turn it up. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. One hop this time. Right foot, let's go. Left foot, let's go. Cha-cha now, y'all. Now it's time to get funky. To the right now. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. One hop this time. One hop this time. Right foot, two stumps. Left foot, two stumps. Slide to the left. Slide to the right. Let's go to work. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. Two hops this time. Two hops this time. Right foot. Reverse. 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 Cha-cha now, y'all. Cha-cha again. Cha-cha now, y'all. Cha-cha again. Turn it out.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are about to begin with our surprise dance. If we can please everyone take their seat. Once again, we're about to begin with our surprise dance. If we can please have everyone head to their seats. Court of Honor, are we ready?
I made a little bit of money.
Give it up, for Court of Honor tonight. And give it up one more time for Mia. Coming up next, ladies and gentlemen, we have our money train. Take your wallets out. Make sure we fill that back all the way to the top. Nothing but 20s in that bag, nothing but 20s. Corvano, please stay on the dance floor so that we can begin with our money train. Ladies and gentlemen,
To give them a surprise, to give all four girls a surprise gift, and we would like to give it to y'all so that all four of y'all can open it up together.
Hey guys, I got my Drake tickets that I've been asking for over like 5 months. Say, what do you have to say? All right, nothing. Anyways, we got to see Drake and when?
September. Okay, so each one of your parents bought y'all's tickets so that y'all can go to the Drake concert.
All right, guys, we're getting ready to begin with our money train. Court of Honor, please line up behind me. Court of Honor, please line up behind me. Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen.
sure you get everyone, yeah, make sure you get everyone. Put it on, 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 put
Bailar un beso y bailarle. Gracias a todos los payasos.